Hello and welcome to this new Quick Take episode. My name is Philippe Oziel. I'm a developer advocate at Salesforce. And in today's show, I'm going to tell you how you can create a custom flow action with Apex. As a side note, I also recorded a similar video on how you can create custom flow screen components with Lightning Web Components. Flow Actions lets you execute custom business logic and integrate with third-party systems within a flow. For example, you can use a flow action to calculate the number of days between two dates or post a file to an instant messaging app. Flow actions are implemented with Apex invocable actions. An invocable action takes input parameters, runs some Apex, and returns output parameters. Let's switch over to VS Code and create a custom action. I'm going to write a simple hello world action. I'll start by creating a new Apex class. Let's prepare wrappers for our input and output. I'm using inner classes for that. For the input, I'm going to take username as a string. I'm annotating it with invocable variable so that it appears in Flow Builder, and I'll mark it as a required parameter. I could also specify a label and description here. For the output, I'm returning the greeting as a string. I'll also add the invocable variable annotation as well. Let's now write the custom logic of the action. It's a static method that always has the same signature. It takes a list of input parameters and returns a list of output parameters. Note that I'm using lists for inputs and outputs instead of a single object. Just like Apex triggers, or invocable method needs to be bulkified. In most cases, you're only going to call it once, but it needs to support multiple requests with a single method call. I add the add invocable annotation to let the platform know that this is an invocable action. You can specify an optional label and a category in the annotation. I really recommend that you add a label here. Another attribute that you can specify on the annotation is configuration editor. This lets you set a custom property editor. I won't cover this topic in details here, but in short, this is something that lets you select a Lightning Web component that replaces the default configuration form for our action. This is useful for providing a custom admin-friendly experience. Back to our action. As I mentioned earlier, the method needs to be bulkified. In order to handle that, you can put in place a simple pattern. Things will be a bit more complex if you need to group SQL queries, for instance, but let's keep things simple for this example. I'll rename my method to bulk invoke. Note that if you've provided a label in the invocable method annotation, the name of the method is not relevant in Flow Builder. I'll add a loop that calls a private invoke method. The invoke method is where I'll place my business logic that handles the single request. Now that my action is implemented, I can go back to Flow Builder and show you how to use it. I've prepared a sample screen flow here with a screen that displays my greeting message. I'm now going to add our action before the screen to generate the greeting message. I'll search for my action label, there it is. I'll enter a label, and I can now set the input and output parameters. For name input, I'll use a global variable that gives me the current user's first name. I can now store the output value. I've prepared a greeting flow variable that I'll use to store my message. Let's now save the flow and run it. That's it, that's how you build and use a custom flow action. This example was very basic, but having access to flow actions lets you run custom logic and allows you to call third-party systems. Invocable actions can also be used in Process Builder, although you don't have access to output parameters in this case. When calling third-party systems, you can also leverage external services to auto-generate code for invocable actions. If you'd like to get started fast with flows, check out automation components. Automation components are a set of reusable and production-ready extensions that include invocable actions, flow screen components, and local actions. These are intended as an easy-to-install, easy-to-use toolbox. And for even more community-contributed flow resources, visit unofficialsf.com. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned something new today. If yes, like the video. Also, check out the video with the custom flow actions. That's similar content. And lastly, if you want to get similar content pushed to you directly, you can hit subscribe and that bell to get notifications as we release new content.